Well, hey there, Howard Olsen, and I want to breathe a little word of encouragement into you today. I want to help you have the breakout year that you were intended to have. You know, a lot of times people ask me, so, you know, what do you do? Well, the simple answer is I help people. I help them clarify their message. I help them clarify and refine their process. I help them get the big white elephants in the room out of the room. I help give them 30,000 foot perspective and look through the lens of their customers so they can connect in a deeper and more meaningful way. And as I've been traveling around the world over these last several years, doing keynote programs and full training programs and culture shifting programs, I've seen this pattern emerge that seems to be increasing in frequency and intensity. I first noticed it about 6, maybe 7 years ago. I'd do a program. Maybe I was doing a keynote somewhere, or it could have been a sales training program. And at the morning break, somebody would come up to me and say, "Man, I love everything you're talking about. It makes sense. It's intuitive. Intellectually, it makes sense. But I'm afraid." What did you say? I'm afraid. Well, what are you afraid of? I don't know. I can't put my finger on it, but I'm just, it's like I got this anxiety. I don't know what to do about it. And I've seen this pattern over and over and over again. And in recent years, in fact, in recent months, it's just increasing in intensity and in frequency with which I encounter this. And so, you know, I'm sitting here thinking about what I'm going to be doing this year, and more of the same for sure. But I've got this sense inside of me that there is this overwhelming grip of this spirit of fear and anxiety that's just got its grip on people. And if that's you, I want to help you get rid of it. I want to help you battle this thing out and beat it, because you do not need to be gripped and afflicted by a spirit of fear and anxiety. And so a couple of years ago, many years ago, when I first started noticing this, I'll never forget this one occasion. Somebody just said, "You know, I'm afraid." And I said, "Well, listen, you know, I don't want to push any kind of dogma or religion on you." I said, "But can I tell you what God has to say about that?" And they were receptive, and they said, "Sure." And I said, "Listen, there's a scripture that comes out of the Bible. And by the way, Bible just means basic instruction before leaving Earth, all right? So your car came with an owner's manual, and your Blu-ray player came with one. Your cell phone came with an owner's manual. Well, guess what? You come with an owner's manual. It's called the Bible, basic instruction before leaving Earth, okay? So forget about all the religious nonsense that you might be conjuring up in your head. That's all it is, okay? It's just an instruction for better living. That's it, all right? So I said to this lady, I said, "Let me tell you can I tell you what the Bible has to say about this?" She said, "Sure, go ahead." I said, "Well, there's a scripture. It's from 2 Timothy 1:7. It's short. And this is God speaking to you. This is what he wants to tell you, okay? If this is the inspired word of God, this is what he's saying to you. He says, 'For I have not given you a spirit of fear, but I have given you a spirit of power, of love, and of sound mind.'" And she took that and received it. And I said, "Now, it seems like a simple little sentence, but there's a lot going on here. Let me help you understand what's really happening here." So if this is God speaking, you're saying, "For I have not given you a spirit of fear." First and foremost, he's saying, "Yep, let's acknowledge it. You've got it, because we can't deal with it if we don't first acknowledge it. Yep, you've got it. Fear, anxiety, worry, all of its derivative cousins, they got a hold in you. But it's not from me," says he. All right. So if I didn't give it to you, if it's not from God, where did it come from? All right. I'm going to let you ponder that one on your own for a while. I'm not even going to go down that hole. All right. So he says, "For I have not given it to you." So you got it, but it's not from me, he says. But there's more. He didn't call it a feeling, and he didn't call it an emotion. He called it a spirit of fear. And here's the reason why so many of you have been dogged by this thing and can't kick it. Because you try to deal with a spiritual problem with an emotional, chemical, or maybe medical solution. Taking a pill, taking a sleep, or taking a drink, while it may mask it for a while, isn't going to deal with the root cause. The only way that you can deal with a spiritual problem and be done with it forever is with a spiritual solution. All right, so he called it a spirit of fear, not an emotion. So we got to deal with the emotional in the spiritual realm. Here's the really good news. In the very same sentence, he says, "For I have not given you a spirit of fear, but I have given you a spirit of power a spirit of love, and a spirit of sound mind. So basically, here's what God just said to you. Listen, I gave you three more powerful spirits that can come capture and cast out that lesser spirit of fear. Would you like to say goodbye to it? And so I was sharing this with this lady. She says, yeah, I don't ever want to deal with this again. I said, all right, would you let me pray for you? And she said, yes. So I prayed for her, and I just watched her whole body physiology change. And she goes, what just happened? I said, I think God just answered that prayer, man. You're not going to have to deal with this anymore. We kicked that spirit of anxiety out. And so what I'd like to do, listen, God is no respecter of time, space, place. It can be a video. It can be YouTube. It can be Instagram. It could be in your living room. It doesn't really matter. Listen, he just wants you to get a hold of this truth. So let me do this for you. I'm going to pray for you in this video, you know, and so if you can just insert your own name, and if you just open your heart up and let this in, all right, so I'm just going to do this. So Heavenly Father, God, I just thank you for whoever's watching this video right now. I thank you for sitting in front of their computer screen or the television screen or their tablet or wherever they are. God, and I thank you for them. I thank you that you love them more than they'll ever know. And I speak to you now. I speak to you, spirit of fear, spirit of anxiety, and all of your cousins and nephews. I command you. I command you to go. In the name of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I tell you, I command you to leave now. You let go of this person. You have no right. You have no power. You have no dominion. You have no legal claim. No legal claim, past, present, or future. By the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to leave this person. You release your grip of them, and you do that right now. I'm not suggesting it. I'm commanding it. I am ordering it. In the name of God himself, I command you, fear and anxiety, not born of God, I command you to go. You let go of them now in the name of Jesus Christ. And I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Father. I thank you, God, that you have given them a spirit of power and a spirit of love and a spirit of sound mind, and that you flood their very being now from the crown of their head to the balls of their feet and from each end of their arm, God. You flood them now with the cleansing power of power, love, and sound mind. You fill the vacuum and the void where fear and anxiety have now left. And I thank you for that. I thank you, God, in Jesus' name, amen. And so, listen, if that was you, you'd let that in, and maybe intellectually you're fighting with this, go back and watch this again and let those words permeate. And I promise you, you can be set free of this affliction of anxiety and worry. You do not need to be riddled with it. And this is why it's so important, because as long as you are riddled with a spirit of fear and anxiety or worry or any of its derivatives, you will never come into the fullness of who you were intended to be. You'll never break through to the kind of successes or the grandeur that you were intended to have. And so let yourself be freed of this thing and then get on with it. Now, sometimes, some of you out there are watching this, you say, well, listen, I don't know about this whole thing. Or maybe you got some friends, you know, listen, I've got some friends that I know from university. I've known them my whole life, you know, in this area, we're on different pages. When the chips are down, you listen, we all have troubles from time to time. You know, they'll send me good vibes or they'll offer to sit down and have a beer with me. Now, listen, I like a good cold beer as much as the next guy. But I know that when I got a trouble, that's not going to fix it. So if that's you, you know, listen, and you need someone to talk to about this kind of thing, I'm going to make an offer to you. In the body of this email, the little button here, it says, click to book a freedom session. You click that link, it'll take you over to my website or to my calendar, give you a link to my public calendar where you can just click. And one of the options for an appointment is for, I'm going to call it a freedom session. You click on that. You find an open spot on my calendar that works for you, and I'll be happy to give you 5-10 minutes where not only can we talk through this, but I'd be happy to pray for you personally the way I just did in this video. I got no tricks up my sleeve. I'm not trying to convert you to nothing. That is not my goal or my agenda. But as I sat here reflecting on what my year was going to look like and what my key priorities were going to be, of course, it's more of the same. You know, training programs, culture shifting programs, helping people, you know, find a better methodology so they can have the kind of business success that they deserve. Okay, I do all of that. But I just really felt, you know, that this spirit of fear is intensifying and it's more prevalent. It's everywhere. And so I see it as one of my personal goals is to help break people free of that. So if that's you and you'd like to take me up on this offer, click on that link and I promise you I'll do nothing but talk with you and pray for you the way I just did in this video and then just leave it up to you, okay? I got no hidden agenda here. In fact, I've always said, if I got a hidden agenda, it's because I haven't found it yet. So this is as open and transparent as I can be. I want to bless you with this. And so go ahead and click the link, and I'd be happy to have a freedom session with you. God bless you. And here's to the breakout year that you're meant to have. Olsen, out.